y'all.
I know I answer questions on my website, my blog, on Tuesdays, but it's a little difficult when I have no internet. Yeah, literally I've had no internet for the past little bit. It's been crazy. It's been like, it'll come on, and I'll upload something, and then the internet will die. And then it'll come on again, and then it'll die again. And it's literally been like every hour and a half. But I believe it's just gotten fixed. It's one of the differences of living in the country versus the city. In the cities that I've lived in, I'm so used to like 4G, super fast, crazy internet. Now I'm out in the country. And it's a lot slower out here in the country. So I was like, oh my God, I have internet. So I figured I should just do a video because I haven't done a video vlog in a while. I might as well answer one of your questions, right? So I got a question, as I am apt to do, because you keep sending them in, and I love you for it. I really love hearing your questions. I love it. Hold on. I'm looking for my... Here we go. Okay. Question. Hi, Angela. I'm a lurker who loves your site and loves your positive energy that even comes through for the computer. I am more of a pessimist. I am more of the pessimist persuasion, and I envy your enthusiasm. Can a person change from a pessimist to a positive person? I want to like myself more and not take everything so seriously, but can you really change? Wow, good question. First of all, yeah, you can change. Everybody does. I've done it. I mean, change. I think you're still the core person, little divine spark of wonderful spirit that you are. I think you're always that when you come into this world. What messes you up is what's going on in your brain. And you said it in the question of, like, you want to like yourself. That goes right back to being a pessimist. Like, I believe the connection to being a pessimist or a grouch or a negative Nancy or, you know, you like that? Is all about what's going on in your head. So yeah, you can move from pessimist to positive playfulness. If you, one, look at who are you hanging out with? Who are you spending time around? Are you spending time around other negative Nancys? Are you getting into constantly like negative conversations? Like, watch who you're spending your time with, because that really does make a huge difference. And it's okay to like trim toxic people out of your life. Totally fine. If you're like, wow, you are so negative and you just hate your life. I love my life. Even I ate a grilled cheese sandwich. I love my life. I want to play every day. I'm not going to spend time with the negative Nancys. Of course, their names aren't necessarily only Nancy. Another thing is, what's going on in your head? Because I've talked about that for years, of like changing the neural pathways in your brain. Just pay attention to what you're saying to yourself in your head. Are you like around people, and everything, every time you are around people, watch the dialogue in your head? Are you saying like, God, I hate her? Or like, I hate these people. Or like, whatever. Why is she wearing that? Or to constant negative speak in your head. Watch it. Because if you're having negative little dialogue in your head about somebody else, it goes back to yourself. Just like you're asking in your, you brought it up in the question of like, I want to like myself. That is the key. You answered your own question. Although I believe you always know the answer to the questions you're asking. You just have to listen to yourself. So, that's it. Watch who you're hanging out with. Watch the dialogue in your head. And also, what are you doing for play? If you want to move from being a pessimist to a more positive playfulness, I added that word. What do you do for play? Yeah, you. And I'm serious. It should be scheduled on your iCalendar. And your iPhone, or your, you know, you should do a Google alert. I'm like, what are you doing for play? And mind you, it doesn't have to be a board game, you know, or you're actually playing a game. You, you know, for play. Like, me, play, I love science. So, like, play for me would be like, ooh, let's go, like, bring out the telescope and look at the stars. Or let's go, like, chat with the Scientific American writer, who I can't even pronounce his name. Let me, like, hurt my brain a little bit, like, learning more about science that I'm so fascinated by. But that's also playfulness for me. So another one would be, like, go be in nature. Huge, huge meditative technique, actually, being in nature. So, like, I ask you, what are you doing for play? It should be scheduled in. Watch what you're saying to yourself in your head about yourself and about other people, and watch who you're spending your time with. Because you can completely move from the, I love it, your pessimist persuasion to positive playfulness. You can! And I love the question, and I thank you for asking, and I just, I love it when you all contact me and stay in contact, and I'm out here in the country, totally out here in the country. I'm on my porch right now, sitting on my porch. Ooh, fancy. Here's my view. One of them that goes roundabout. This is my porch. I'm sitting on the ground right now. And I just love you. And thank you so much. And I hope you're having a wonderfully playful day.